Okay, I just wanted to do one more video on multiplying polynomials. And specifically, I wanted to do multiplying binomials times trinomials. Now, you're probably not going to get this in your course, but I wanted to throw it in, first of all, because I thought it'd be nice to be complete about different ways to multiply polynomials. And also because you might find problems like this if you use some of the exercises on the Khan Academy website, and I didn't want you to be stuck when you got to them. So here's the kind of problem we're talking about. This is 2x minus 3 times the trinomial 3x squared plus 4x minus 2. And actually, something like this is really pretty easy. We're going to set it up similarly to the way you probably set up multiplication problems back when you were doing just arithmetic, arithmetic multiplication. So I'm going to take this, the 3x squared plus 4x minus 2, and I'll just write it here, 3x squared plus 4x minus 2. And underneath that, I'm going to write 2x minus 3. And just like an arithmetic multiplication problem, I'm going to take this 3 and multiply it by each of these terms. Okay? Now, this is really pretty easy because really all you're doing is multiplying monomials times monomials. Here's how it goes. Negative 3 times negative 2 is a positive 6. Negative 3 times 4x is negative 12x. And negative 3 times 3x squared will be negative 9x squared. Now I'm going to multiply the 2x times each of the terms in the trinomial. So 2x times negative 2x is negative 4x. 2x times 2x times 4x is 8x squared. You notice what I'm doing is lining up my terms. Over here I've got x's over x's, x squared over x squared. Okay, so to go on, 2x times 3x squared will give me 2 times 3 is 6, and x times x squared will be x to the third. And now, just like in regular multiplication, I'm going to add each column. So adding the x to the third column, I get 6x to the third. I go on to the x squared column, I've got a negative 9 and a positive 8. So that's going to be a negative 1. So this is just negative x squared. Negative 12x and negative 4x. Well, adding two negatives gives you a negative. So this will be negative 16x. And then I've just got a 6 here. And that's my answer. Okay, really pretty simple. I want to do another one. There's plenty of time. Okay, so here I have 3x squared plus 4 and x squared minus 2x plus 9. So let's write the x squared minus 2x plus 9 and 3x squared. I'm going to line that up under my x squared term. Let's fix that 4 plus 4. Okay, you don't have to put this under the x squared term. I find it helps keep things neat. Okay, so now I'm just going to multiply 4 times each of these terms. 4 times 9 is 36. Put my positive sign in. 4 times negative 2x is negative 8x. And 4 times x squared will be 4x squared. Now I'm going to multiply by 3x squared. So 3x squared times 9, 3 times 9 is 27. So going to my x squared column, I've got 27x squared. 3x squared times negative 2x. So 3 times negative 2 is negative 6. X squared times x is x to the third. So this is going to be negative 6x to the third. And I've got 3x squared times x squared, so that will be x to the fourth. Okay, adding up my columns, I've got 3x to the fourth minus 6x to the third plus 27 plus 4 is 31. 31x squared minus 8x plus 36. Okay, so even though this seems like a big problem, it's really just a whole bunch of very little and very simple steps. Okay, I hope you found this useful. Take care. I'll see you next time.